Isaiah chapter 35, verse 3, and it reads, "Strengthen ye the weak hands, and confirm the feeble knees. Say to them that are of a fearful heart, be strong, fear not. Behold, your power will come with vengeance, even Yahweh with a recompense. He will come and save you." First and foremost, I want to give all praise, honor, and glory to the Heavenly Father and His only begotten Son, Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Rakakwadash. Next, double honors to the head apostle / elder bishops of Great Millstone, the ones that taught us the 100% truth according to the Bible. Peace, blessings, and safety to all you sincere items. Keep pushing, keep believing, keep the faith, regardless of people here for a bit. For those who are troubled, rest with us. One Lord Yahweh Shai shall come with the heavenly hosts, taking vengeance on them that know not the gospel and that obey not the Most High. Another video of exhortation. You know, we prophesy, we tell you what's going to happen before it even happened, according to the Bible. Our power, great deliverance is coming. Great deliverance is coming. That should be our mind state. Deliverance, salvation. That should be our main focus, salvation. Forget all this other crap that's going on in the earth. Don't get caught up in none of this nonsense. Our mind is focused on salvation. The hope for elect, our mind is on salvation, man. So all I'm thinking about, just salvation. The Lord coming back. Seeing our Creator, man. We're one day closer. Suffering is almost over. It ain't going to last forever. But the Lord says it's light affliction. The things that we're going through right about now, yeah, it's tough. It gets aggravating at times. That's why we got to constantly pray that the Lord keeps His Spirit on us to endure. Because salvation is coming. Remember, it's high time to wake out of sleep, because salvation is nearer than when we believe, right? Let's get it again. Isaiah 35 and 3. "Strengthen ye the weak hands, and confirm the feeble knees. Say to them that are of a fearful heart." The heart goes back to the lob, which means your mind. Always worried about something. You see what's going on? This system is crashing. Everything getting expensive, going through the roof. So Jake worried about how they're going to eat, how they're going to take care of their babies. We go through this all the time through the Spirit. It's all about repetitiveness. Reminding Jake, reminding ourselves over and over each and every day, the Lord is on His way. Right? Say to them that are of a fearful heart, that mind. Don't know if you're going to get pulled over by the police and get deaded or get locked the hell up on false charges. You don't know what's going to happen. You don't know if they're going to take your kids and do something. You just don't know. In this wicked, perverse system, this world in general, being ran by the wicked, the Lord says, soon coming, ain't going to be no more sorrow. Ain't going to be no more tears. We ain't going to have to worry about this hard bondage. Say to them that are of a fearful heart, be strong, fear not. Your sleazy, you get ready to come in with wrath, fear not. You're going to lose your job? Fear not. You're going to lose your home? Fear not. You're going to lose family members? Fear not. Behold, your power, Yahweh, through His only begotten Son, Yahweh Shai, will come with vengeance. See, the Lord coming back with vengeance to pay the people back that did us wrong. The Lord is going to pay them back. We ain't got to lift a finger. The Lord is going to pay them back, man. Your power will come with vengeance. Even Yahweh with the recompense, meaning payback, He will come and save you. That's our faith, man. We have been given the gift of faith that the Lord is coming back to deliver and save us, man. Out of the clutches of our enemies. And it's nearer than what we believe. 2 Thessalonians chapter 1, verse 6. "Seeing it is a righteous thing with the Most High to recompense tribulation to them that trouble you." We're being troubled on every side. The Lord says it's a righteous thing with Him to pay the people back that's doing us wrong. That did us wrong, that's still doing us wrong, and that don't have no intentions on stopping. The people that's ruling the earth, Sleaze, Esau, Edom, and these other heathen nations, they don't plan on, they don't, it's no thoughts in their head, you know what I'm saying, to stop doing us wrong. They don't plan on not doing us wrong. That's all that plan consists of, is doing us wrong, doing us harm, keeping us at the bottom. Just toying with us. Gas go up, gas go down, food go up, food go down, rent go up, rent go down. Deletion on top of deletion. Oh, yeah, we shall overcome. We're not going to do it anymore. Deletion on top of deletion. Lord says a righteous thing with him to pay these people back. They're troubling us on every side. And look, they're not going to stop. And to you who are troubled, rest with us within the Comforter. When the Lord Yahweh Shai, who they even call Jesus, shall be revealed from heaven with his mighty angels. That's what the Lord coming back with, the heavenly hosts. And it's going to be beautiful. And look, in spaceships, in flaming fire, taking vengeance on them that know not the Most High, and that obey not the gospel of our Lord, Yahweh Shai, HaMashiach. That's what we're waiting on, man. The Lord to come pay all these wicked people back and deliver the elect of the nation of Israel. Lord willing, we're part of that number. That's our mind state. That should be your mind state, you hopeful elects out there. Just waking up with thoughts of deliverance on your mind. Let's get Baruch right quick. This ain't a long lesson because I got to get ready to head out. All we do here is work. All we do here is slave. Baruch chapter 4. That's all we do, and it's almost over. These heathens are going to work for us soon come. Just remember that. You see? Baruch chapter 4. Verse 21, be of good cheer, O my children, the children of Israel, so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. We're the Hebrew Israelites, not you heathens, man. We're the children of the Lord. And everybody's about to find out. Be of good cheer, O my children, cry unto the Lord. Remember, set a mark upon the foreheads of the men that sigh and cry. And he will deliver you from the power and hand of the enemies. That's why we're crying unto the Lord. Because we're in the hand of our enemies. We were captives. We're slaves. 2023, we're still slaves, Israel. No one set us free. Look, Israel, one more time. No one set us free, all right? George Washington didn't set us free. Stop believing that BS. You're not free. You got a birth certificate. You got an ID. You got a social security card. You got a passport. You're a slave, man. All right? For my hope is in the everlasting, that he will save you. And joy has come unto me from the Holy One, because of the mercy which shall soon come unto you from the everlasting, our Savior. Let's jump down. 24. Like as now, the neighbors of Zion have seen your captivity. These heathens seen us going to head first, seen us going to captivity, right? Head first. So shall they see shortly your salvation with great glory. Them chariots, right? Them ships, right? Them spaceships, right? They're going to see the elect of the nation of Israel being beamed up into them ships, man. Them spaceships, the chariots. So shall they see shortly your salvation from our power, which shall come upon you with great glory and brightness of the everlasting. You see? It is coming. My children, suffer patiently the wrath that has come upon you from the Most High. For thine enemy have persecuted thee, but shortly thou shalt see his destruction. That's our hope, is to see the downfall of our enemies and shall tread upon his neck. Look, we want to see this happen. Matter of fact, let's just get this. We want to see this happen, man. We want to see, Israel in his right mind wants to see the downfall of his enemy. We ain't playing no games. You Israelites are crazy as hell out here. You happy with your enemy ruling over you with vigor. You see, with pride. Sirach chapter 25, verse 9. Sirach chapter 25, verse 9, and it reads, there be nine things which I have judged in mine heart, mine to be happy. The tenth I will utter with my tongue, a man that have joy of his children, which here in Babylon, no matter where you are, you can't enjoy your babies. The state owns them. The state owns your babies, man. A man that have joy of his children, and he that liveth to see the fall of his enemies. That's what I'm waking up thinking. That's the only thing I'm thinking about, seeing the downfall of my enemy. That's all I'm thinking about, man. I ain't thinking about nothing else. Just thinking about the downfall of my enemy. Set a mark upon the foreheads of the men that sigh and cry for all the abominations that be done in the midst thereof. The Lord said, look, he's getting ready to take away the sorrow. He's getting ready to take away the pain. He's getting ready to take away the hard bondage that was made to serve upon these heathens, man. It's going to be beautiful, man. You two-thirds, y'all love being up under this devil, the slave master. Let's get this. Micah chapter 4, and I'm about to wrap it up. Micah chapter 4, verse 10. Be in pain and labor to bring forth, O daughter of Zion, like a woman in travail. For now shalt thou go forth out of the city, and thou shalt dwell in the field, and thou shalt go even to Babylon, aka America, the land of confusion. There shalt thou be delivered. We're going to be delivered from Babylon, man, and the rest of the earth. The elect, Lord, when are we of that number, man? For now shalt thou go forth out of the city, and thou shalt dwell in the field, representing the world, and thou shalt go even to Babylon, where thou shalt be delivered. There the Lord shall redeem thee from the hand of thine enemies. Can you dig it, Israel? Because the greatest deliverance is going to be here in Babylon. And then you got the rest of the elect being delivered throughout the four corners of the earth, the rest of the world. This is going to be phenomenal, man. It's a beautiful story. We went through rough waters, but we're at the end of it. Let me get one more, then I'm gone. Let me get one more scripture, and then I'm gone. Cry unto the Lord, Israel. What does it say? Fear not, thou worm Jacob. What is it, the 40th chapter? Isaiah chapter 40, I'm thinking. Let's see, bear with me. Bear with me. Or is it 41? Bear with me. Isaiah 41 and 1. 144, right? Fear not, thou worm Jacob. We're defenseless right about now. We ain't got no power. We're at the bottom of society. We got to go to the enemy for the want of all things. Hell, you can't even rule over your woman here in Babylon. We're defenseless. You can't whoop your babies, but Israel still, that's how you know Israel is really bugged the hell out. You can't even whoop your woman. You can't even whoop your woman. And that dude, he got slayed by the police. He was committing adultery. They ain't going to bring that out. They're justifying that dude's wickedness. That dude, he got slayed by the police. He was committing adultery with one of the police officer's wives. They ain't bringing that out, though. That's why we got to get the hell out of here, man. Nothing but wickedness goes on here. Isaiah 41 and 14, fear not, thou worm Jacob, and ye men of Israel. I will help thee. The Lord's getting ready to make his men more precious than fine gold, man, and give them that true power. I will help thee, saith the Lord Yahweh, through his only begotten son, Yahweh Shai, and thy Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. That's our mind state. And I mean, I can go on and go on and go on to the break of dawn. But you get the point, man. We got to cry unto the Lord, man. More and more, we got to cry unto the Lord. Let's see if I want to get this last one. Isaiah, the 19th chapter. Because I got a roll. Just want to throw something out there, man. The Lord says it's a righteous thing with him to recompense the people that's been troubling us. Isaiah chapter 19, We'll start at verse 19. In the day that Salakia, in that day shall there be an altar to the Lord, meaning these different camps, right? The true men that's teaching the words of Yahweh by Shem Yahweh Shai, right? In that day, meaning these days, there should be an altar to the Lord in the midst of the land of Egypt. Spiritual Egypt and Sodom, right? Babylon, America, right? And a pillar at the border thereof to the Lord. And it shall be for a sign and for a witness unto the Lord of hosts, the Lord of armies in the land of Egypt, Babylon the great, America. For they shall cry unto the Lord Yahweh, Bahashem Yahweh Shai. Right? Remember, set a mark upon the foreheads of the men that sigh and cry for all the abominations that be done in the midst thereof. For they shall cry unto the Lord because of the oppressors. And if you're not crying unto the Lord because of the oppressors and the oppression, something wrong with you, Israel. Because oppression maketh a wise man mad. And a gift destroyeth the heart, meaning the mind. For they shall cry unto the Lord because of the oppressors. And he shall send them a Savior. Lord Yahweh Shai, the Heavenly Father is about to send his only begotten Son, our Savior, man. And he shall send them a Savior and a great one. And he shall deliver them. That's our mind state. It's high time to wake out of sleep because salvation is nearer than what we believe. Our power is on its way, Israel. Shalom.